Wait a minute. 2021 is already getting better than 2020. Although, didn't Shield Wall come out then? I don't know. But we have a massive update to Shield Wall. They're adding, get this, the Egyptian faction.
The Battle of Farshaflesh.
Oh, and then there's missions 9 and 10. But I think if I go to battle, Egypt with Ramses, Cleopatra, and Ptolemy. Ooh, Ptolemy was very Greek faction. So what we're going to be doing today is taking part in this. But I want to see what the Egyptian faction is all about. So we're going to be going to... Let's just take a look at their heroes real quick. So we've got Ramses. There's Ramses, Cleopatra, and Ptolemy. So... Oh, check out... Ramses. So before we jump back into the action, I want to say a big shout out and thank you to Dragon Tamer for sponsoring this video. Dragon Tamer is the ultimate turn-based strategy game that tests your skills in taming and mastering the art of dragonry. Now in Dragon Tamer, you're going to be able to breed your own dragons and turn them into over 100 different unique dragons. In this game, there's really endless possibilities. Now you have to grow your dragons in the game, taking them from a little egg to a hatchling to a youngling and a full adult. And each of those dragons will belong to one of nine elements in the game that each can benefit or limit one another. Along with growing and breeding the dragons, there are six flying islands waiting for you to decorate and to plan. You can make it your own fiery dragon world. And it wouldn't be a dragon game if you couldn't battle them. Dragon Tamer has seven completely different modes, including two PvP modes, like the Arena, which is a one-on-one match. And then there's Alliance Warfare, where an alliance leader can select up to 20 members to fight against other alliances in a 14-day season. And then there's the four PvE modes, Space-Time Rift, Mythic Mountain, Alliance Boss, and my personal favorite, Adventure Mode. It's got a range of difficulty options and 10 chapters each with 12 stages. There's an idle reward and auto battle mode feature that I absolutely adore. And lastly, there's a unique minigame mode called Force of Spirits, which is completely different from all of the other modes. You control a Viking warrior to explore the bushes in the forest. You may find various rewards or monsters behind the bushes. The best part of this game, though, is you'll be fighting with other dragon trainers from around the world because there is only one global server. So anyway, guys, if you want to breed and grow the coolest dragons ever and take them to battle against others, make sure to check out Dragon Tamer by clicking the link in the video description below. Okay, now if we spawn in some units here, now let's see. Militia, what does our militia look like? Oh man, that is just, it's hitting it on the head. These are perfect. Okay, now how's Cleopatra in a metal bikini? Look at that eagle, and her sword looks awesome. It's like the Kopesh, and she's kind of got the half moon shield. Now, are her militia the same? I would imagine so, but it would be kind of cool if they were somewhat stylized a little bit different. Right? So they've got those kind of like almost tombstone looking or rather shaped shields, and they've got their short spears. So let's actually press tab here. We go from the spearmen to warriors and the warriors to the Pharaoh's guard. The elite. Oh man, those guys are gonna look awesome. Now let's see the final leader, Ptolemy. So we've got new missions. Oh, Ptolemy, bro, you're like, you know what I like? I like cool hats and goatees. And that's exactly what I got right here. His shield looks even more impressive. He's got some more armor. This guy must have been a warrior king. And soldiers much the same. So this is going to be awesome. Now, as far as which leader, I think we got to go with Ramses just because he looks the coolest. But they also added the mission 9. And mission 9 opens Act 3, which is mission 10, where you first start to get a play with the Egyptians. The AI was improved. And apparently there's 5 new music tracks too. So, I mean, I'm just so excited for this update now. This caught me completely off guard because if you look at the man, the myth, the legend, Nezon Productions Twitter, and Twitter is one of my favorite ways to follow like indie game devs and get caught up on news. So if you guys want to follow my Twitter, you can. Some of the stuff that you wouldn't normally see on the channel goes up there. But if you look at this, like we haven't heard from Nezon since October 26th of 2020. So it's been some months with no word. And then all of a sudden, bam, Pharsalus and Alexandria are locked. Those are the ones we're going to be wanting to get. But this is, consider this a faction preview. So we'll be fighting Julius Caesar and Vercingetorix. All right, gentlemen, I don't speak Egyptian, but my God, do I have a cool mask and an amazing war axe. Now we're gonna let the two, these two guys fight. Now, I believe I'm at unit cap of 19. Let's see. Yep, the limit of units is reached. So basically we're gonna let the barbarians of Gaul, barbare, if you speak Latin. There was a really cool Netflix show about that. Go get them, boys. Maybe I shouldn't let them cap the flag. Let's see if their respawns come in here. Yeah, okay, so shieldmen aren't nearly as aggressive. They like to stay in formation, and the green guys are already coming as well as the blue. So we'll pull back a little bit and let blue and green keep duking it out. My goal right here is to save up gold while they're fighting, and I'm thinking it's time to get a standard. So, did the standard, will he pop up near my flag when I'm close? Because apparently the Egyptian standard also. Standard bear, there you are.
Oh my god.
Whoa. Anubis would be so proud of this army. Now, let's take a look at our standard. Okay, so we have melee damage, health per second, flag capture speed, gold per minute, and higher cost. Higher cost, is that new? And look at this. All of these have hieroglyphics, and as you combine the hieroglyphics, they can get additional rules. So that's going to be one of the things we're going to want to do. But essentially, right now, the additional rules are simplified. You just combine two of the same thing. So this one is block, and then the bird is gold per minute, and then the more elaborate one is HPS, health per second. I think we want the birds. The bird is the word, after all. Because you, let's see, who's holding blue? All right, as blue dips out to either go fight green or something, that's when we are going to try to take the middle point. Essentially, the economics that's going on right here are called war economics. War economics. And the more men we lose, the more we have to spend on getting them back. So we want to take this gold per minute and save up as much gold as possible to try to get a tech advantage or numerical superiority, or preferably both, over the enemy forces. Green is coming in, blue's coming in too, so we will let them fight. But I want to see if I can't. Now, I have no experience points, and I'm only going to get them from fighting. So what we do here is let them duke it out, and we hold this flag, and we kill whoever is the victor. All right, is it time to intervene? Yeah, it is, because Gaul is just getting absolutely routed. And as our men get destroyed, our standard bearer has no sign, so he's just holding what looks like a glorified spear right now. And we will replace our casualties in the spawn point of this flag, and I think this is a pretty good map to show off the Egyptians in a very, you know, orderly fashion. So let's, this is kind of nuts. Increasing your gold per minute by 20% is, oh, I was looking at the wrong one. Okay, so we know what they do. 10 plus 10 is 20. It'd be cool to see, like, maybe a little bit more. So now we went from 90 to 99, because, hey, guess what? You multiply 0.1 times 90, and guess what? It's 9. So we got 99, although essentially you'd want to multiply 90 by 1.1. All right, we'll pull back. Hopefully green comes soon. Rally to me. You know what? We're going to fight them because green is coming in. As our guys die, we'll get more. A few of my spearmen are holding them off. And you know what? Let's use this battle axe, man. Hey, I am the pharaoh. You can't do that. Swordmen attack a little bit faster, so they're absolutely routing my men. I almost fell off a cliff. All right, guys. All right, guys, on me. Let them do their thing over there. We just got to hold the flag and keep the gold superiority here. Yeah, so I need to upgrade my men ASAP, but unfortunately, since I committed to this battle, I'm now back to like 90 gold. Now, do we have time before the reinforcing waves get here? Yes, we do. So that's the cost of engaging in these battles. We did get a decent amount of experience, right? 80 experience for that. Was it worth it? I don't know. We got to see if we can work it. We have to drop their army down, flip the script on their attacks, and reverse it. All right, blue is coming in, and is green. Green's more on schedule this time. So we pulled out. We got to have a very strong pullout game to essentially assure that blue and green will aggro to each other. Green, the Gauls are taunting them. Oh God, that's my standard bearer. I was like, who's that? It's an ambush. All right, you know what? And we got another one. So let's get that gold up. So now we're at 108 for holding the middle flag. So an extra 18 gold per second. Plus, if we look at the map, our home base is 180 and this flag is 90. So I guess you could upgrade that, and I think it might be in, yeah, the aura of the standard. My standard bearer being in the zone increases the gold. I think we got another one too. So we already have one crane. Is it a crane or some kind of a pelican bird? Now let's see. Gold per minute, hit points per second. Oh, see, I don't have any damage. I don't have some of these. I want the higher cost one, but we do not have that available. I'm gonna concentrate on maybe a few more birds and then go some of the other ones. All right. Now, I think the coolest thing we're going to want to do is see the new units. So we will get the warriors now. And then with the next 200, we will increase our unit cap. And as our militia get replaced, we'll be able to summon in a lot of the new warriors that I think will be Egypt, maybe a little bit not as strong with our tier one. And that's essentially what this is tier one you start out with. Then there's tier two and tier three. But the Pharaoh's guard are probably going to be awesome. Oh, hello. Hello, Barbare. Get them, boys. Keep them off our flag. Blue is not marching in yet. They're saving up gold. They might be doing some military reforms, some upgrades. Oops. All right, where's a warrior? I'm trying to summon them in. I may have, I see like one. He's got a little silver head thing on his headdress. We'll keep them off our flag. So I was summoning in militia on accident, just out of habit. I swear it never happens. We'll replace our losses because there are quite a few. So now these are all warriors. There may be one or two spearmen, and the standard bearer did level up. Wait, did they just retreat? Hey, Oh, I hit my standard bearer. I'm so sorry, friend.
Shoo.
All right, so we've held the line here. So now, do I want to keep fighting? Green and blue, they're offset on their spawning, so this is where it can get expensive because I can't just let them fight each other. But I'm pretty sure I can't tell if they have tier 2 infantry yet. Oh, wait, some of their guys have bigger feathers and some of them don't? All right, let's spear them from the side so that I can kind of be a force modifier here, a force multiplier. Okay, I have 2 points available. I'm gonna get even more gold. So now this flag went from 90 to 135. Who's yelling? Who's yelling? And look at that. Look at our standard bearer. All right, we like birds. We are big fans of birds. We like to watch birds and put Hold on. I may have missed the opportunity here. Yeah, this is bad. Can I run through this bush? I cannot. The bush is invincible. That may have been a tactical error, but I'll respawn these guys in and just blow the gold. Yeah, essentially I'm fighting two armies. This is an expensive mistake. I am in danger. Hello, Caesar. Caesar. All right, your neck, mate. Oh, wait, you're alive. Hey, chill out, bro. My standard bearer's got a little present for you. All right, so we're down to like no gold, but we may have gotten the timing of their attacks the same again. But if you look in the upper left, the team points are drastically in our favor. So our goal of getting to Pharaoh's Guard is slowly but surely on its way. All right, blue's attacking. Green, come on. Green, dude. Dang it, Green. Now you're coming. All right, we will pull away from this and save up the gold. We've been riding it for a while. We can let them take this. You know what we could do is, if they take that, should I just take their flag? You know what? I'm feeling a little cheeky. I think blue will win that one, so maybe green was the one we'd want to attack. All right, boys, we're going to be taking some Roman pilum, and unfortunately, they have a door. Yeah, right in your head. Pick back up. There we go. That guy's dead. I always wish there was a little bit of an aiming indicator here. Oh, we're in. Oh, God, we're in the base, but they respawned here. All right, so that was a fool's errand there. We will retreat and lick our wounds. Oh, that's a full army chasing me. Dang it. So I think in that case, we probably should have attacked green, but hindsight is 20/20. It'll help from our friends the Gauls. There you go. Thanks, guys. All right, you nuts. So now we will take this flag, hopefully fast enough. Standard bearer went up a point, so let's get that gold, boys. We get those upgrades. I don't know if we're gonna be able to hold this. Are there blue and green alive? I'm dead. Respawning in 10 seconds. We'll have to go back. Okay, so Pharaoh's Guard. Now, how cool are Pharaoh's Guard? Whoa, they got some big old hats. They got body armor. Still, the star of the show is definitely Ramses. Put that one on the wall. Oh, that's cool. You can see the health of your wall there. All right. You may have killed me, but I am an immortal. Oh, you what, mate? They are attacking me. I take that as an offense. All right, boys, hold the line. All right, and I am in the aura, so am I getting even more gold? Of course, the door's closed behind me. It's like, that's the one thing I would change. And we just wiped them. We just wiped them. And we lost maybe 4 guys, so that shows the power. This is supposed to be producing 180 on the map, but we have it at 306? Oh, my. Okay, so staying here and teching up seems to be the course of action. We are going to increase the number of soldiers we can get from 20 to 25 with our next 200 gold. They said lots of visual style with the Egyptian units, and I couldn't agree more. We have the Greeks, the Gauls, the Romans, and the Egyptians now. There we go. We have max units. All right. Now, is the army gone? I need to silence one of them. I don't see anybody. It's very strange. Blue apparently won the battle. Are they attacking green space, or do they just wipe each other out? We got to take this flag ASAP. I guess upgrading your attack speed's good, but I love how they just kind of pause because it gives you time. Maybe the AI should have a little bit more urgency there. All right. Oh, man. Biscuits and gravy. But look at how much we should be winning. All right. So now health per second could be really good. So we'll start getting our health back. Then we'll survive more battles and I'll have to spend less. All right, boys, get the Gauls. And I feel like if there were better combat mechanics, I would fight more as a general. But generally, it's like the cost-benefit analysis here is a little bit rough. Because like if you die as a general, your army falls apart. So maybe having a little more power so there's a risk-reward there. The reward being like you do a lot more damage to the enemy. Yeah, but definitely, man, getting that, getting the standard bearers that boost your income and sitting back at your main flag point seems to be a good idea. Ooh, standard bearers done. So we will get that. So now we have 0.4 hit points per second while in this. So it's like this just became a fortress of its own. All right, it's time. They both have doors. So let's see. Actually, let's stay here. No, let's let them fight. What I need to upgrade is gate crashing. All right, we're going to go back to the home base. So we're about halfway through, 14 minutes in. And I'm thinking what we do is looks like Gaul is winning that one. We're going to get this guy in the standard bearer. So this boosts it from 180 to 306, so we can just get massive amounts of money. Yeah, and like, so it makes more sense to come back here because I don't have to spend for reinforcing troops. These guys are attacking me. You freaking what, mate? All right, don't shut the door until all of our men are out, or that'd be a disaster. I lost some men. I need a, you need a toggleable switch or a button so that the gates don't close behind you. You can operate that, or if everyone's dead, they automatically close, because I do not like being cut off. All right, so now I'm thinking we get spear. No, we'll get the standard bearer sign. Oh, move speed, health per second, or gold per minute. Oh my gosh, I should have gotten that ages ago. We're at 378. We've doubled what this flag point should be producing. The Egyptians are all about that cash and all about that grain too from the Fertile Nile River. Like, look at how much gold I'm getting per second. Is blue taking a peek at us? Hopefully Gaul comes in and smacks you a booty. Yeah, there they go. Okay, I guess I should have seen that and been going after one of them. We're gonna go after one of their bases. No, we're not. We're gonna capture the flag and time it better, because blue will die, they'll respawn, and it's just our timing would be off. Now, will they just keep respawning? Oh, the horn, I think, increases the gold to 40, so they're respawning everybody. That's okay. Guess blocking would be good. We gotta get it, right? All right, boys. Oh man, green's coming in. Blue should be out of gold. I'm thinking, you know what we do is if we can capture this fast enough, yeah, I just get the reinforcements and wipe out Gaul. I should have let Gaul take it. Man, I want to see if we blow. Oh yeah, blue's basically bankrupt. All right, so we'll keep him off the flag point. We'll wait till he comes in with like two or three guys. He's essentially bankrupt. If he's coming in with not a full army, we are slowly winning this war of attrition. Flag healing aura. Let's do that. So all of my guys, I wish I could press like some button to see their health. All right, that's a full army. And that's a full army. So now's time to wipe one of them out. Pick and choose. Pick your poison. We're choosing the Romans. Although the Romans are red, and I feel like Egyptians, we should be yellow, maybe? But red does look pretty sweet. So they haven't even taken the flag. Oh, I got him and he got me. There we go. The guard is dead, but now their army's here. We're gonna just push through this. Take down the gates! Kill everybody! As long as green doesn't attack my fort, we should be fine. I'm trying to get through here. There we go. We busted through. What am I stuck on? Bodies. Let the bodies hit the floor. Oh, and green actually retreated. Oh, there you are, Caesar. All right, you want to do this? How about a spear in your nostril? Your left one. Oh, I missed. There we go. Cut him down. Green is going in. We refill the army, and it looks like we're going to be fighting green right here. The gate is being repaired, and I'm thinking it's time to buy some pilum because we just have so much gold. Now, this is cool. If you haven't seen in Shieldwall an entire legion of your best troops firing spears all at the same time, well, you're missing out. And it looks like we're gonna have a siege here. It'd be cool though if like you could buy siege equipment, get a catapult, a scorpion, a ballista, something like that. Siege tower, battering ram, I don't know, to attack these enemy forts. All right, it looks like green wants a battle in the field. Oh, we kind of missed there, but we hit a bunch of them. Gentlemen, keep fighting. We almost have, oops, I accidentally, there's a little bit of friendly fire there, actually. No, don't tell anybody. Kill Vercingetorix. We will get reinforcements here, and we will push. Now, this is the toughest part of any battle. What I need is more pilum and more pilum, because there's going to be these guards, and we're going to try to pilum the one on the right and the one on the left, then gate crash. Oh, let's stay out of range. Stay out of range. No reason to fight in the range of theirs. All right, so essentially, the AI, though, is smart. Egyptians seem to be fighting. Maybe everybody's a little bit fighter formation, so they go testudo, but all you gotta do is be a little patient. But look how cool. See, that's shield wall. Now they're gonna charge in about 3, 2, 1. Oh my God, I timed that right. I totally knew it the whole time, no doubt in my mind. And they're dead. We have the elite Pharaoh's guard. Now I think we should have one pilum left. Testudo, stay close. Stay close to me. There we go. Now hit the gates. Crash those gates. And they're waiting for us on the other side, boys. What? You have like 80 spears in your face. Get them. Slay them all. Horns on cooldown. We may not be able to get through this first wave, but the gates are down. Oh, shield bearer's dead. Don't worry, gentlemen. I will go get reinforcements, and you will go get to see how great the afterlife is, all right? Once we get there, boom, all reinforcements all the time. Oh, and they're coming out to fight me. Okay, so hopefully the gates will still be down by the time we finish this. Let's see. Flags protection or gate repair time. I'll do a little bit of that. All right, boys. Come on, we got to get there. Look at that. Look at all that red paint. All of our blood, sweat, and tears are all over that gate. We must get back in before they can repair it and close it. What I liked is Nezon Productions made this old game called Formata, and I really liked it. And, oh man, we gotta get there so they can't just choke point us. Don't Thermopylae me in here. Oh God, that's a little fence. I can't see. I would love where, like, when I go to throw my spear, I turn transparent or something, because I think I'm getting my butt kicked, man. Oh, my standard bearers. Oh, yes! We did it! Hold the middle. We'll test Dudo up against that spear as long as we can. If we can take this flag, then we will have won the war. And then it's just mopping up. It's mopping up time! Because now this base is mine and I can build infantry. And that is a victory for the new Egyptians. So it looks like the enemy wasn't able to really get their upgrades going. It doesn't look like they even got their standard bearers. Now, there was some updates to the AI, but I wonder if it affects how their prioritization of things, or on a simpler map, my strategies are much better than on the new ones, which is where we're going to be checking out the next campaign mission. So if you guys do want to see more Shield Wall, let me know by pulling the trigger on the like button. Let me know in the comments and subscribe if you're new. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.